An empty lantern provides no light. And that is the thought for today. Today's episode of the 7 Good Minutes Daily Self-Improvement Podcast is being sponsored by Carbona. A stain-free and clean home is something you can be proud of, but it's hard to maintain when you're using cleaning products that don't work well or take forever to use. Q Carbona, a household brand that has turned their decades of cleaning expertise into products that get the job done fully, quickly, and easily. When I heard about Stain Devils, my thoughts about removing stains changed forever. Think about this. If you have a chocolate stain, it wouldn't make sense to treat it with a formula that removes wine. They're chemically different. Shop Carbona.com, and for a limited time, listeners of this podcast get 20% off your order. That's Carbona.com, and don't forget to enter the promo code 7GOODMINUTES at checkout for 20% off your entire order. And now, on with today's episode of 7 Good Minutes. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's audio, we hear why it's very important that you spend some time focusing on yourself. Enjoy.
No amount of money will ever make you wealthy, because as soon as you get there, you will raise the game, because growth is life. But having to grow in order to feel significant enough means you will always be poor. It's a game that never ends. Let's talk about money now, not wealth. What does it take mechanically to get this thing called financial independence? And what is financial independence as opposed to wealth? Wealth is a product of the mind. Again, no amount of money you ever achieve will make you wealthy.
Life will pay whatever price you ask of it. But you know what's interesting? You gotta ask intelligently. Now, if you were gonna ask intelligently, there might be 5 elements of that. Number one, you'd have to ask specifically, wouldn't you? You wouldn't ask in a general way. People do it all the time. They go, I want more money. Fine, here's a dollar, get out of here. Very often, you're getting what you're asking for. You're just not aware of how general you're asking. Clarity is power. The more clear you are about exactly what it is you want, the more your brain knows how to get there. Your brain is a servo mechanism. It's like a bomb. Those bombs, those missiles, they have a servo mechanism. So if the target moves, it knows what the target is, it follows it. Your brain, when you condition it, knows exactly what to go for, and it'll find a way to get there. But when you decide what's most important to you, your brain goes after it. Everyone I know who's successful builds what I call an RPM plan. An RPM is built on the metaphor that the way to get from where you are to where do you want to go to the fastest is you got to build power, like in a car, RPMs. And the R stands for they know the result they're after. They know what they want precisely. If you don't know exactly what you want, or you let yourself get beyond that to something general, you're not going to achieve it.
We all have goals. The problem, as I've said before on this program, is that we're unconscious in the use of our resources. Most people's goals are to, quote, pay the lousy bills, or to get by, or to survive, or get out of debt, or make it through the day, make their relationship a little better, get a better job. In short, they're caught up in the trap of making a living rather than designing a life. Remember that our goals affect us, whatever they are. If we don't consciously plant the seeds of what we want in the gardens of our minds, we'll end up with weeds. If we want to discover the unlimited possibilities within us, we must find a goal big enough and grand enough to challenge us to push beyond our limits and discover our true potential. Remember that your current conditions do not reflect your ultimate potential, but rather the size and the quality of the goals upon which you're currently focusing. We all must discover or create a magnificent obsession.
Whenever you look at somebody and say, why are they more successful than anybody else? It's always because of step one, they've raised their standard. If you go back home and you want to change your life in any way, personally, professionally, or your company, as boring as it sounds, as stupid as inane it sounds, because even though that's not sexy, it is the only thing that creates lasting change. You can go on a diet and you can lose weight, but what will that person eventually do? They'll go where? Back, unless they raise their standard. Now that sounds so trite and stupid and positive thinky or old school, but the truth is it's the truth. So maybe I can language it in a way that's more compelling to you or more simple. What does it mean when we say raise our standards? It means you turn your shoulds difference in people is that they've turned their shoulds into musts. The things that you used to say, I should do, you do your shoulds when it's convenient, when it's comfortable, when it goes your way. But when something is a must, not to other people, but a must to you, do you find the way to get it done, yes or no? So the difference in people is what's their must, or another word for that is what's their standard.
If you want a great jump in the quality of your life, an extraordinary jump in the quality of your life, you gotta set yourself up to win. You gotta set yourself up with a process that allows you to consistently grow, consistently enjoy your life, and consistently produce the results that you're really after. And I don't care.
But if you've got what you know, that focus, the target, and you got the toolbox, and you're still not getting what you want, it's because you got inner conflicts. That's the third pillar. You gotta resolve your inner conflicts. Because that, as I try to explain to you, 80% of success in anything is your psychology and 20% is the mechanics. So those inner conflicts are when you take two steps forward and you pull three steps back, right? When you say, boy, I'm totally committed to this, but you don't follow through. This is my expertise, the why guy part. Why? Why do you keep saying you want this? You have crystal clarity, you have the tools, and you're still not getting it. There's a conflict in you. You want to be totally successful, but you're afraid at some level that if you will are totally successful, you will not be loved. You'll be rejected. You want to be in a position where you have total free time and you want to build a billion-dollar enterprise. These are conflicts.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.